Hello students, I hope you all are doing well at home and watching videos regularly. Welcome in SST class day 3. I had discussed introduction, definition of fundamental rights and various fundamental rights with explanation in my last two videos. I hope you have understood the topics. Before we start, I want to take feedback of the previous topics through cross questions. Number 1. When did India become independent? When did our constitution come into force? When do we celebrate Republic Day? Who is known as the father of constitution? What do you mean by constitution? Give definition of the following terms: preamble, democratic, socialist, secular, and republic. What are fundamental rights? Write all the fundamental rights. I hope you all are able to answer all these questions. Now, today I am going to discuss the topic fundamental duties and directive principles. Let's discuss the objectives of fundamental duties and directive principles. The objectives are: number 1. What are fundamental duties? Why is there a need of fundamental duties? What is the importance of fundamental duties? Give some fundamental duties. Mention some important guidelines given to the central and state government. Before we start the topic, let me discuss terms of today's topic. Number 1. Fundamental duties. Basic duties for the citizen. Number 2. Directive principles. The guidelines given to the government to run a welfare state. Number 3. Laws. Rules made by the government. Now let's start reading from book. Take out page 128, topic fundamental duties. Fundamental duties. Rights and duties are like two sides of the same coin. One loses its meaning without the other. So our constitution lists certain fundamental duties to the citizens. Constitution, I have already discussed with you, a set of rules according to which a country is ruled. Citizens, people who were born and live in a country. So students, I have already discussed with you that rights and duties are like two sides of a coin, absolutely inseparable. Whenever and wherever we have any rights, we must have corresponding duties, whether it to be the home, the school, the society, or the country. In every sphere of life, both rights and duties go hand in hand. Now let's continue. Some of the duties are: number 1. To respect the ideals given in the constitution, the national flag, and the national anthem. Ideals means adarshon. So students, we must give respect to our national flag and national anthem. As I have already taught you in the chapter, our national symbols. We should not talk or move about when our national anthem is sung. We must stand at attention. We must keep our national flag carefully. Or when the national flag is hoisted, we must stand at attention and salute. So students, it is our duty to respect our national flag and national anthem. Next, number 2. To cherish and follow the noble ideals which inspired our national leaders. Cherish means love or care. Inspired means encouraged. Means to say that we should love or care the noble ideals that encouraged or motivate our national leaders for freedom. Like Mahatma Gandhi, Bhagat Singh, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So students, it is our duty to respect our national leaders who fought for our country to get freedom from the Britishers. So students, it is our duty to give respect to our national leaders. Next, number 3. To stay united. United means joined together. Means to say that we must stay together. Because there is a proverb, united we stand, divided we fall. Simply means to say that If we work together, we can be successful. If we fight each other, we will fall. So it is our duty to stay united, to make our country prosperous. Let's continue number fourth point. To defend the country whenever necessary. Defend means protect from harm. So students, it is our duty that we must protect our country whenever it is required. Next, fifth point. To value and preserve the rich heritage of our culture. Preserve means to maintain. Heritage means property that is inherited. Culture means customs or traditions. Means to say that it is our duty to maintain our cultural heritage like Taj Mahal, Agra Fort, Qutub Minar, etc. We can preserve it by not scribbling on the walls, by not throwing waste things. So students, it is our duty to participate in the regular cleanliness drives. Let's continue number sixth point. To protect and improve the natural environment. Protect means save, environment means surroundings. Means to say that we must take care of our surroundings or the natural world. It is a moral duty to save our natural surroundings and keep it free from pollution by growing more and more trees. Last seventh point, to protect public property. Public property means hospitals, schools, parks, roads, railway station, etc. These are built by the government for public use. So students, it is our duty to protect public property because it is built for the public welfare. It is a part of the country's infrastructure. So we must protect them. Damage the public property affects the country's progress. So students, we must take care of public property. I hope all these fundamental duties are clear to you. Now, next topic is directive principles. Directive principle means the guidelines given to the government to run a welfare state, or means to say that some instructions are given to the government while framing laws. Students, come to the next topic, directive principles. The directive principles are the guidelines given to the central and state governments while framing laws. Guidelines means rules. Laws means rules made by the government. Some important guidelines are to, number one, provide proper living condition for all citizens. Means to say that the government should understand the basic needs of the people. Must provide proper hygienic conditions, medical facilities, proper drinking water, electricity, and proper drainage system, etc. Second point, ensure the rich do not exploit the poor. Ensure means check. Exploit means utilize or make use of. Means to say that the government must check that poor people are not made to work without pay, and also check that rich people not treat the poor people unfairly in order to get some benefits. Must check the rich people will not force two children to do work. Must check on child labor. Next, third point. Provide free and compulsory education for children up to the age of 14. Students, I have already discussed with you. The government should provide free and compulsory education to children up to the age of 14 years. Last fourth point. Improve the conditions of scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other backward caste. So it is the guideline given to the government to improve the conditions of scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other backward caste. To give them facilities like subsidies, low rate interest, better education, reservation facilities, job facilities, etc. I hope children, today's topic is clear to all. So your homework is reread today's topic and do exercise. ABC on page 129 on book. Thank you.